wanna, you know, eliminate someone because they report a date on the payment. I always like to think about what worst case scenario, what do we do? So if we can't interview them both before the board meeting, we might have to have a special board meeting to do it. And a date soon after the 21st. I mean, it's not, I don't think it's that hard to do.
I will contact the firms tomorrow via telephone. And also a written letter will be given out, but I'll check on their availability. And if there's any issues or conflicts, I'll let the subcommittee know and then we can go from there.
Okay.
Can I raise one other just procedural Brown Act issue we could think about for your next meeting? So it'll come up before then or after the meeting, which is you will be taking an action. The committee will be taking an action. You have to allow public comment before that action. So you may wanna think through now the process. And what I was hearing is perhaps it would be is that the interviews would take place. Members of the public could be present during those interviews. The interview section would be closed. You'd move to your action item. Public comment would be allowed at that point. You can either make a motion and public comment on it, or you could do it even before the motion. And then the recommendation, discussion, recommendation, and the action. So I just wanted to lay that out. That's something you might wanna consider now, so you don't have to try to sort that out.
Thank you. Yeah, I think it's, I like the idea of doing it that way. You know, having it on the agenda that we're gonna have public comment after the interview. Do you all agree with that?
Yep.
So I think we have some motions to vote on.
So do we need to motion all these agreement, all these ways we're gonna move forward with this work? Or do we, how do you recommend the motion? What do we need to motion on relation to discussion, just add around interview, attorney, public conflict of interest?
I think we have to make a motion about, you know, the 4 points again.
Yes. So for discussion, I'd like the motion approval of next steps.
No, but you, okay, but the items were.
Yes, next steps in relation to these items, interview, preparing for interviews, attorney proposals, conflict of interest, getting ready for interviews on the 20th, or having, conducting interviews on the 20th, and recommendation from subcommittee to the board on the 21st.
Well, I think the one action was that we agreed that we would take questions from the public and that we would have a deadline, that would be.
No deadline.
No deadline, the no deadline deadline.
If I can perhaps assist on that, I tried to write out a motion based on what I understood to be the action items. So perhaps I can review that and see if I captured it all.
Yes.
And I can't guarantee I did. But the motion would be that the next steps include the following process. One, the RFQ responses will be released with the agenda packet to the committee. One of the issues we talked about. Two, the staff letter inviting the firms to interview will include an instruction to inform the committee how the firm has determined that they have no conflict. Three, committee members will prepare their own questions and will consider any proposed questions submitted by the public. And four, public comment will be allowed after interviews and before a recommendation is made.
Can you read the first one again?
Yeah, the RFQ responses will be released with the agenda packet to the committee.
Oh, of course, the proposal. Okay. Yeah, I was thinking of them as proposed. Okay, yeah. I think that does capture it.
And then what about the agenda items for next meeting? Is it need to be in the motion or not?
I don't know that it does. I wanted to make that one part of the public comment clear because there's a decision as to whether you take that public comment before the interviews or after. And I have a feeling the public would probably feel it would be more useful after rather than before.
Is there anything that precludes us from having both?
Just a matter of timing. The attorneys, if they've been told this within a certain window.
What would be the point of having them before?
I don't know, maybe somebody really wants to say something before we start, and then we just want to give you an opportunity to speak after we've heard.
mean, there could always be something that someone wants to say beforehand. I guess the question is, does our process, does that improve transparency?
Well, here's my question, in relation to what we decided, that anybody can make comment on any item on the agenda.
Oh, okay.
Can we entertain that in the beginning? Doesn't that give that space to do it? That's protocol, that's right, that's protocol. So in other words, I mean, you can make that happen. I don't need to worry about that then.
I mean, we could have a public comment, but have a time limit.
I think we just need to ensure it happens. That.
Well, that would be discussing.